Oke, okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning everybody. We meet again in this week with the topic. It's a new topic about the wireless communication. Everybody can hear my voice?
Yes, sir. Waalaikumsalam yes, warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, thank you. Okay, yeah, this is a bit shifting from the previous topic about the NGN. And today, until today, I mean this week, until at the end of this class, we are going to talk a lot about wireless communication technology. Okay. As for the introductions, this is the first thing that I have to tell you. This is the wireless history. Yes. Okay. Okay. In ancient system, yeah, the communications, yeah, is taken place using natural signal. You can see here the natural signal that I mean is using a smoke signal. Like a carrier pigeon, something like that, by putting maybe paper message on their foot, and then they will bring to the destinations, something like that. So the receiver can read our message. Also, maybe in our culture, maybe to those who live in Java, in the maybe I'm not sure that you are even live in Java, still experience about kentongan, kentongan, you know, kentongan. For example, it's for asking people to gather in some place or to give information about the some event or fire burning, something like that. Okay, and those technology was used in the ancient time, yeah. And then people tried to innovate, yeah. Tried to make a better way to send a message. So the electromagnetic era, I mean. Which is started by the radio invention by Marconi in 1880s, yeah, by Marconi sending a message using an electromagnetic signal to broadcast to anywhere using the medium of air, or in this case is electromagnetic. And then this improvement of development, this technology is very, very rapid, yeah. Used not only for commercial but for military, yeah, because the military area, they are most intent to use this system, because military usually is depend on the how many project they should develop and to create a new technology. And usually in military, everyone or to those who advance the technology, they have a lot of chance to be winner. That's why innovating in technology, particularly in the electronic or in communication, is very, very important. And you remember, maybe if you read the story or history, that at that time, at the Nazi, when Nazi wants to attack, if I'm not mistake, US allies, and then this radio, no, actually not radio, but telegram, yeah, this telegram, the decoded telegram message from the Nazi broadcast to the, maybe the truth, yeah, and then can be intercept, yeah, can be intercept by the US allies, so they can open the message, so the US allies can anticipate it, yeah, the invasion of the Nazis, so they have a better chance to prepare the war. So it's contribute to the being winner at the worldwide two, something like that. So that's the point when we advancing the technology, in this case is a communication system, we can grab the future, something like that. Okay. Move forward to the commercializations. Yeah, as you know that the growth of cellular system, maybe you already familiar, like a handphone that you can communicate, this is using a cellular system, was established since 1980, something like this, 1980. And this development until today is very, very rapid. And if you can see here from the data, this is the data, this is the billion, the number of user, and this is the time with year, yeah. The data is gathered from 1999 and until now, and you can see here the demand, I mean the user, yeah, the user growing very rapid, yeah, very fast, and this is still growing, yeah, currently still growing, yeah. Okay, and this data we can maybe make a short conclusions that this demand ignite the wireless revolutions. Means that this is propel the wireless technology. And also talking about the information, you can see here, the information is not only voice anymore, but data and multimedia ubiquitous, yeah. Means that many types of multimedia. And again, and as the technology disseminated, I mean deploy in the more wide area, including the third world countries, yeah, maybe still developing countries, yeah, the number of users also increase multiple times, yeah, you can see here, yes, something like that, this is the data from the increasing user time by time, years by years, yes. Okay, let's move forward. Oh, okay, and then still Wi-Fi also enjoying tremendous success and grow, and you can see everywhere there are many Wi-Fi, yeah, there are many Wi-Fi signal, yeah, something like that, not only in the public space, but sometime in the private space, like apartment in the home complex, yeah, in home area, yeah, home area, I think we are experience many Wi-Fi signal. Wifi is everywhere. And then also the Bluetooth technology, also we can use almost every day, like for connecting to devices, yeah, to devices, for example, for extending our speaker to the Bluetooth speaker so we can enjoy more delicious voice because maybe Bluetooth speaker has a better voice or sound output, something like that. And then satellite also growing. You can see if you follow the news from Elon Musk that he is developing or even putting many more than 1,000, yeah, 1,000 satellite at our, yeah, our ceiling, yeah, our ceiling, I mean our atmosphere, yeah, put many satellite over there to serve communications, to serve internet services, something like that. And those satellite era is still growing, yeah. Maybe in the last decade, the owner of the satellite is at the level of state, but right now the owner of the satellite currently become level of a private company. That's incredible, yeah, because means that usually the technology or service owned by state, usually they are costly and less benefit, yeah, usually, because the purpose of this service usually military service, security service, yeah, to the state. So sometimes the cost is not being considered. But from the perspective of private company or commercial company, the number one point is to get profit. And currently the satellite already commercialized, yeah. So it's mean that the message is the satellite service currently become give a benefit, can take a profit from this business, something like that. Okay. Let's move forward. This is we are going to talk about the future wireless network. Yeah, what future wireless network? You can see here from the picture. Yeah, we can easily that building, and then this is maybe a monument, something like that. And this is the infrastructure, transportation. Yes, and this is the what we have, a smartphone, and this is the human activity, something like that. Is we are approaching to the connection world, means that everything can be connected and communicate each other to exchange information, something like that. So the application is still growing. For example, next generation cellular or Wi-Fi, yeah. This is the very hot topic, you can see, yeah. Maybe in 3 years ago, we just experienced about the 4G, right? 4G. And currently we are facing for the 5G. 5G. And in China, currently they are developing 6G. Yeah. This is the growing technology that very fast evolutions. And then the application of smart home or space. Yeah, smart home. Maybe I think your home already experience about the smart utility, smart metering. You can unlock the door wirelessly. You can turn on and turn off wirelessly. You can make a surveillance, video for surveillance wirelessly. You can check home condition anytime from anywhere using your smartphone by equipping your home using a maybe smart camera, something like that. And those equipment already available at the market, yes. And also autonomous car, and this is technology also growing, yeah. You know Tesla Model S. The current model is Tesla Model S plate. Wow. Yes, the fastest car in the world. Only 1.99 second from 1 until 100 kilometer per hour. Wow, yes. Okay. And they also can drive by themselves, yeah. And this kind of technology also has been developed by other many company, like you can see Mercedes-Benz and BMW, or even Wuling Almas. Wuling Almas, maybe you are already familiar. They can steer, they can drive by themselves. Oh, yeah. Interesting. Yes. Also, smart city means that the infrastructure and the management combine to create services to their citizen. And also body area network. So currently you are experienced with a wearable device, like for example, Apple Watch, yeah, Apple Watch, Samsung Watch, maybe, and many watch, yeah, that equipped by a sensor inside, yeah, like a gyrometer, accelerometer, and pulse meter. So you can enjoy by using this smartwatch. You can monitor your body health, yeah, body activity, for example, pulse, heart, maybe how many calorie that you spend today, and to make a more balanced life, something like that. And of course, Internet of Things. Yes, Internet of Things means that Internet of everywhere, Internet of anything, yeah. Means that anything, anywhere can be equipped, yeah, can be connected to the internet networks. Yes, that's the future, yeah, of the technology. Okay, and many more, yeah, of course. Okay, let's move forward. So the era, the communication is not only from people to people. Yeah, at the beginning, or the maybe 10 decades ago, when the technology just been invented, the purpose is to communicate human and human. Means that for example, voice. Yeah, we are call our relatives. Yeah, in different place. Yeah, actually we are just only the device as a tool to delivering our voice to the receiver. But currently, the use of telecommunication system or telecommunication network is not only people, but also device to device, or we can say machine to machine, yeah, machine to machine, and people to machine. And right now already happened. Maybe you experience Google, what we can say in our headphone, Google, I'm sorry. In iPhone, they have a Siri, yeah, Siri. Actually, Siri, we are talking with a machine, yeah. So they kind of communication people to machine, yes. Using Google or using another platform, it's similar. Yeah, we already happen, yeah. It's already happened. And right now, move forward to the machine to machine. Machine to machine is kind of sensor to sensor. Sensor to sensor. For example, if you have an IP camera that available to conduct motion detection, what is the motion detection? Yeah, your camera CCTV can be yeah. Let's say allow me to say like Xiaomi ya, Xiaomi 360. Yeah, IP smart camera. This camera, this smart camera can detect the any motion, yeah, any motion and baby crying and people detection. So, using this camera, can trigger the people awareness, yeah, the people awareness, yeah. For example, if you put this camera for security purpose, put on the maybe your carport, yeah, at your home, and then we activate the people detection, motion detection, and then using this feature, we can record any activity, yeah. We can record any activity, so we no need to record all the time, but only record when the some motion detected or some people available at the around the camera. So, what is the purpose of this feature is to save the space memory. Yeah. So. When we use this feature, so we no need to record all the time, but we only record when the feature take place. For example, there is a people, and then the camera will record something like that. That's kind of feature that example of device to device. Or machine to machine, because the communication take place from the camera. Camera communicate to send the arounds and then make an action to record. Yeah, or another feature, not only record but also push notification to the owner, so we can. Being notified by the camera that there is people detected or there is a motion detected, something like that. Okay, that's kind of device or machine to machine communications. Yes. Okay, let's move forward. And then how to realize that kind of technology, how many challenges, and what kind of challenge that we have to face it. When we are talking about the radio wireless network, there are many challenges. For example, first is gigabit per second data rate with no error. Why this is important? Yeah, you can see here that the application become more various. You are enjoying the high definition video, right? And this high definition video require higher data rates, usually in the level of gigabit per second. Or even you are using CCTV camera with high definition, so we can see more clear object. So that's kind of camera requires, yeah, high data rates. So it is become important to provide data rates with high level performance. Yeah, and then the next point is energy efficiency. It is important since the device are increasing. Yeah, device the number of device is increasing. Maybe you are right now. Every people, every one of you, maybe you have more than one smartphone. Maybe, yeah. But I believe that you have more than one computer. Maybe you have a laptop, and then you have a PC. Maybe, yeah. And then you have a tablet, something like that. And you can imagine that only one people use at least three type of communication device. And you can imagine that if every people use like you, so the number of the number of devices increase, and this device should be power. Yeah, you should be powered to make this up. Yeah, to be can be used. So it should be power using electricity. It means that the electricity demand, the power demand also increasing. So when the increase, our PLN maybe enjoy, yeah, because they have a lot of money, they get a lot of money. But in other words, they also have to provide the energy resource, something like that. Some kind of this, sometimes it is a very challenging. So maybe if we are limited by power, yeah, for example, in the when we are recording video, usually when we make a recording video, it consumes so much power, and this power is very deteriorated our smartphone lifetime. So it's gonna be turned off soon, yeah, when there are no electricity, no power from the battery. So the challenge of efficiency, it is important. If you last time, maybe in this 13 September, 13 or 14, I'm not remember precisely. Apple, yeah, Apple presented a new iPhone, yeah, iPhone Pro 13, yeah, iPhone 13 Pro, yeah. If you compare to the previous generation, I think that there are only small feature, yeah, maybe several feature that already improved, but some of the several feature that has been improved is about the battery life. The battery life is important. Yes, Apple concerned about this, and many devices also concerned about Samsung and something, and other devices also concerned about the battery life for their smartphone. Because yeah, when we have a longer battery life, it means that they have they can enjoy, yeah, they can serve more longer, so make a customer happy, something like that. No need to charge the phone many times, yeah. Okay, and then the third point is scarce spectrum. Scarce spectrum mean that as you know that the wireless communications deliver through the air. Yes, it is correct, but the most correct, they deliver using a spectrum, using wave, and this wave is limited. Yeah, electromagnetic wave, this is limited. So even from 0 hertz until unlimited hertz already been Oh. Everybody can see, can hear my voice?
Yes, sir, we can hear your voice.
Oh, okay, sorry. There is a disruption. I don't know. Okay. And then, and this this spectrum, as I mentioned, that actually the wireless technology like radio FM, radio AM, or even 3G, 4G, 5G, if you are experienced, maybe I said many times that, for example, the radio FM, yeah, radio FM, they works in 188 megahertz, yeah, megahertz until 18 megahertz, means that this spectrum already been used, only dedicated from the from for this radio, and maybe you are experienced with 2G 800 megahertz, something like that. I mean 900 megahertz, yeah, megahertz. So usually each technology, each wireless communication technology has been designed for a dedicated spectrum. So this spectrum becomes scarce, yeah. And then the point is about the reliability and coverage. Reliability means that the ability of the system to provide a good service. We can say I wrote from the news that maybe about 10 hours ago, Telkomsel and Telkom are experience a black, maybe reducing the speed of internet because of the fiber optic between Batam and Pontianak cut off. So this fiber optic cannot deliver the internet data. So the impact of this, the data that should transmit to this network being rerouting to another network. And the impact of this, maybe some of you experience lower data rates because the traffic are incoming from anywhere, yeah, from many places from many source. So the traffic become very very crowded and become congestion, something like that. So the reliability, it is important. Yeah. Okay, and then about the wireless coverage. Okay, before we get talking about the coverage, maybe more related to reliability in term of wireless is when we are communicating, when we are communicating during mobile, maybe when you are in a car or in a train and you make a call or you watching a streaming video, streaming something like that, and how to provide a good performance, for example, with no lag or with smooth transitions, something like that. That's kind of reliability in the wireless communications. And then the another important is coverage. Yeah, you can imagine that maybe if you are going to the some very remote area, there are no signal. Maybe if you are experienced on the pendaki gunung, yeah, maybe they are experienced with low coverage or low signal, something like that. So the purpose in wireless communication is how to achieve as loud as possible for the telecommunication coverage. So when we have a large coverage, mean that we can serve many users. When we can serve many users, so we can get more user. Yeah, of course. When we get more user, we can generate more money. Yes, something like that. Okay. And then next point is heterogeneous network. And hetero means that many type of networks. Of course, you are now experienced in many type of technology or wireless technology. You are experienced with 2G, you are experienced 3G, 4G, yeah, and Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and maybe I'm not sure, something like that. And this should work together, should work seamlessly to provide a good reliability in terms of service. As you know that the coverage 2G, 3G, 4G, maybe 5G are not uniform in everywhere, right? Sometimes your smartphone changing by themselves from 2G to 3G, or if we have experienced lower signal, maybe change to 2G. That's kind of mechanism that reflects about the heterogeneous network. Heterogeneous network means that in one place there are available network technology. Yeah, yeah. For example, 2G, 3G, 5G, and Bluetooth. Yeah, something like that. And then seamless internetwork handoff. Yeah, this is important in wireless communication. Why? Because one of the important thing in wireless communication is they should provide mobility user. Yeah, mobility user means that the user should be still connected while in mobile. Yeah, for example, you are make a call to your mother from Bogor to the Jakarta, and you are you are using a train, yeah, MRT, yeah, and then you make a call from Bogor to Jakarta, and this mechanism actually what happened in the communication, your phone actually being served by the BTS in Bogor. Yeah, this is still connected in BTS in Bogor, and then your train is moving heading to Jakarta, moving, and this move away from the BTS in Bogor. So in this case, your signal, your handphone receive a weak signal, and this weak signal can decrease the quality of your voice. Yeah, your voice. So this handphone should be served by another BTS, the closer one. For example, this is BTS Depok, yeah, BTS Depok. So this is being cut off and then connected to this BTS in Depok, and then you enjoy the connection again. You can still continuing your phone to your mother, and this mechanism also happened in Jakarta. So usually in Jakarta, they have on BTS, and then your handphone when experience a weak signal from the Depok, and then you will be connected to the BTS in Jakarta. That's kind of mechanism means that there is a connected and unconnected process, yeah, during your moving, yeah. So this kind of connection and disconnection process, we can say as a handover or handoff. Handoff means that give the service to another BTS. So in this mechanism, and this mechanism is critical because physically you are being disconnected through the signal from the BTS from Bogor and establishing new connection in BTS with Depok. And process establishing, it should be taken in very short time. So you don't experience lag when you are making call, something like that. And this degree of performance, it should be kept. You should be maintained as good as possible, something like that. So it is not expected if you are maybe when holding a phone and we're still talking at phone, and then you change the BTS service, and then your signal is end, and your phone is being, how to say, and your calling and disconnected, and this is very very disappointed in them from the perspective of user. So this kind of the challenge in terms of the network and radio. And then we move forward, challenge in terms of device or SoC. SoC is system of on chips. Yeah. Maybe if you are experienced with the opening the electronic circuit in your smartphone, but I don't suggest, yeah, because I worry that you can repack again. Okay, but you can see here, this is kind of inside of your phone, consists of cellular module, Bluetooth module, memory, CPU, Wi-Fi module, GPS, radio module, millimeter wave module, and many module, yeah, something like that. And this device should be good in terms of performance, yeah. And maybe last week or two weeks ago, I said that currently our smartphone, the performance of our smartphone already comparable with our laptop or PC. Let's take a look from, for example, the capacity of the hard disk. Yeah, the hard disk right now maybe 120 gigs. It's also similar with our phone. Yeah, or even from the RAM. Currently, maybe the latest Samsung phone already available for 8 RAM. Wow, interesting. 8 RAM. Even my laptop from my office is still 4 RAM, yeah. 4 giga a bit RAM, yeah. Yeah, the performance should be good, yeah. Okay, the complexity also getting harder, yeah. Because if you look at your smartphone in very compact device, they should able to compute, for example, make a presentation using a PowerPoint, should make a call or video streaming, a game, and video, yeah, watching a movie, something like that. and should be powerful, and this how to combine into one compact device also, this is very challenging. Size, power, cost, and energy, that's kind of this factor, it should be combined properly to design the best the communication device. High frequency or millimeter wave, this is why we talking about the high frequency, because as you know that people demands high data rate, and this high data rate only can be provided using high frequency, and this high frequency can be delivered using millimeter wave. And also to deliver the high frequency, they are also perform a multiple antenna scenario. You are experienced now MIMO, yeah. If you don't realize that your iPhone since 2014, actually the iPhone product already equipped with 2x2. There is 4 antenna inside of your smartphone. Also the Samsung, since if I'm not mistaken, since 2015, your phone is equipped with not only one antenna, but already 4 antenna perform multiple antenna device. And then multi-radio integration. Multi-radio means that multi-frequency, multi-work frequency, means that your smartphone can use for cellular, for Wi-Fi, for radio, for GPS. Actually, this technology, this service has on spectrum. Yeah, has on the spectrum, yes. And then coexistent. Coexistent means that your smartphone your smartphone can be used, yeah, for a certain period of time. Means that if you buy a new phone, maybe a 5G phone, your phone should be able to, yeah, connect to the 3G phone or even 2G network, yeah, 3G network or 2G network. Means that your phone not only for 5G network, but they has to be able to connect to the lower technology. That's the meaning of coexistence. Okay. This is the software-defined radio. Means that the one of possible technology that can be solution of the device challenge is software-defined radio. Means that the radio is not only for one module, but we can see the radio as a software. Radio as a software. So we can provide or we can generate the high spectrum bandwidth of signal. And then the more interesting is the DSP, the software defined radio can be programmed. So we can use for any technology. The imagine, this is, for example, this is a software defined radio. We can load or we can install many type of technology. We can install 2G, we can install 3G, and we can install 5G, or even we can install beyond 5G. That is possible because inside of this device is only like software processing. And I want to show you something about the SDR, software defined radio. I'm one of the SDR enthusiast. I want to show you a demo how to build radio FM receiver using software Divine Radio. Allow me to okay, first I want to show you the device of software Divine Radio. Actually, there are many types and many level of cost. And right now, if you can see, yeah, this one is Hack RF1. Hack RF1 is one type of software Divine Radio. Actually, what is this device? The device is like small PC that design dedicated for radio programming. So using this device, we can program any technology, any wireless technology. You can program this device as a radio receiver. You can program this device as a radio FM transmitter. Also, it can be done. You can program this device as a 2G receiver, like a smartphone. You can. Or even you can program this device become a smartphone, 5G smartphone. Yeah. 5G smartphone or beyond. Why it is so powerful? Yeah, because this device is designed, the design is not hardware, yeah, means that we attach the modulator. Yeah, physical modulator. No, we replace those kind of device using computing technology, something like that. So allow me to show you that this device consists of, this is the antenna, and this is the LED indicator to see the performance of this device. And also the another device, this is a data connector. This is a USB micro for data connector. And this is for clock, yeah, clock in, clock out. These two purpose is, one is for the input, one for the output. Clock input, clock output. What is the purpose of this? Is for connected to another device. That kind of another device. If you have for example, two device, something like this, and then you can combine, you can connect to the another device. What is the purpose of the connection? Is to perform multiple input, multiple output. Yeah, because you can see here, this only one port for antenna, and if you want to perform multiple input, multiple output, so you have to connect to another device, something like that. Okay, and this device and the antenna is universal. Yeah, actually you can attach any type antenna, but you have to be carefully that this port should be compatible, means that you have to buy an antenna that proper to be attached, something like that. In this case, I use this omnidirectional antenna. It's very traditional antenna. If you are experienced, it's old radio. Yeah, you can use it. Yes. Okay. And for one thing, and this is connection for data communication, means that you can program this device from the computer, and then this code will be burned up to this device and to make this device works properly. Yes. And then I want to show you a demo how to build the radio FM receiver using this device. Okay, I will set up another computer. Okay, I will join a meeting to make you can, how to say, see. Wait a moment. 8171 0787 65 61. Okay, cool. And then the meeting password is 54 69 52. Okay, go. What is it? Okay. And then I want to. Actually, no. Okay. I will use a different computer. Install using and then I want to use this. Okay, yeah, everybody can see, yeah. I will log in my Linux. Okay. So everybody can see.
Yes, we can see it, sir.
Yes. Allow me explain a bit. This kind of SDR. This is a Linux platform, and then the Linux use GNU Radio Companion. GNU Radio Companion. I will spot it. No. You can see here GNU Radio Companion. You can install at your Linux. And then you can make a program. You can make a program like this. And later I will explain. But and this is the USB cable connected to the software Divine Radio here. And you can see this is the antenna connected to this one, and then back to this, and you can see here, yeah, this program is kind of a block here. Yeah, block, each block represent the function. For example, this one for receiving, yeah, receiving signal from SDR, and this is actually the analog signal, yeah. And then also we are setting frequency or the radio station here. And then the output of this one, we pass through the low pass filter, so we can get the voice information from low pass filter, and then this one to convert from complex signal consists imaginary and real part, right? And then this one should be multiplied by a constant to produce a real signal, only real signal, because the speaker can only be input by real signal. There is no imaginary signal for the speaker, something like that. So actually, for this frequency sync or quiescing here, actually to provide a visual representation of spectrum, something like that. So that's all. Oh, once more, you can build by yourself, yeah, and then you can try by yourself, something like that. And it's time to play, yeah, something like that. So you just press this like a YouTube button. Okay, something like that. Okay, let's okay, you can see here in this site, this is the code executed by this program, something like that. And you can see here, this is a spectrum of the electromagnetic signal, and the highest spectrum here, high magnitude, I mean, means that the location of the radio station. You can see here the number. Maybe I will zoom in or zoom out. Yeah, yeah. You can see here it's written around 102.9. Yeah, oh, yeah, something like that lah. Around 100.3 lah. Yeah. So this is the station radio, yeah, it broadcasts this voice. And also you can change to another, yeah, for example 9.9 here. You can see here this is a bit higher than others, means that there is a station here. Yeah, there is station 99.5, 100.5, yeah, something like that. In here also 96.7, something like that. Yeah. Actually there has a voice, yeah, you can see here. Do you hear the voice from the radio?
No, sir.
No, sir. Wait a moment. Actually, the voice is the radio is playing about dangdut. Can you hear?
We can hear little, sir.
Little, yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's change the station, the radio station. You can see here is 103 megahertz. If you count the total of zero, total will be megahertz, yeah, megahertz. Megahertz mean that 60, right? Okay. We try to move to another station radio, maybe 9.9, 9.99.5, yeah. So here. 995. Okay. No voice. Let's. Let's find another station. This one? Homemade, ya. 93 megahertz. Oh, 93 ya. 30. Kok gak mau? Dapat ini 91,7 ya. Oke, let's try 91.7. Wait a moment. Wow, also this is a dangdut as well. You are enjoying? Yeah, maybe we can search another one. I'm not sure. There is no. Yeah, okay. I think that's all. Oh, once more, maybe the next one. This is for spectrum for the voice, yeah, the human voice or music voice. This is you can see here the unity is kilohertz compared to this one is in megahertz. For example, 110, it's mean that 110 megahertz, something like that. And yeah, that's all for the demo. I hope you enjoy. Okay, yeah, just you can press the rectangular button. Okay, that's all about the demo. I will leave the meeting. Okay, for this device. Okay. Okay, back to the PowerPoint. Wow. Yes, you can see here. Yeah, that we just make a demo about the software Divine Radio. Actually, I have another. Yeah. This version is a low cost device. There are many versions that more advanced device, and fortunately I also have from the National Instrument and for the ceiling So the total I have four SDR and with different range of price and different range of the performance. Okay, if you are interested in to develop the related technology about the software defined radio, please contact me and we can discuss a lot. We can discuss more about this technology. Okay, let's move forward. Okay. This is another problem. The challenge in the today's era. Sorry, your airwave are full. Airwave mean the spectrum allocation is almost full. Yeah, almost full. Yeah, so to deliver a very high data rate, it is very challenging right now because actually this is the task of government, means that to regulate the proper spectrum to deliver kind of high data rate services. And you can see here that the application of Internet of Things is a growth linearly, means that still growing for many applications. You can see here most of the people use the IoT for connected home is around, you can see here the composition of the blue one is the largest among others. And the second is for connected work, to connect the works in the office, something like that. And then another is for connected health, connected city or smart city, connected car, and then manufacture and supply chains. And also there is a retail and energy and for the others. That's kind of broad application of IoT, yes, and still growing. And actually, what is the IoT? Enabling every electronic devices to be connected to each other and the internet, include smartphone, consumer electronics, cars, light, clothes, sensor, and medical device, and etc. Value in IoT is data processing in the cloud. Yes, because usually the IoT sensor or IoT device is only a compact device, a small device that consists of a sensor or multiple sensor that attach to the CPU, small CPU with limited processing capabilities, and then equipped with a small of battery capacity, battery power to support their life for long times. So it's mean that this IoT device should perform very efficient in terms of energy and efficient in terms of information. They should as efficient as possible to send information, very limited information, since that if many processing processing power or processing information, so it will be deteriorated the power, and when the power is exhausted, and then this device become useless. And this IoT is designed not for replacement, but is designed for one-time deployment. Yes. And this is many area, wide area application of IoT applications, IoT device, consumer smart infrastructure, security and surveillance, transportation, industrial and manufacture, and retail and healthcare. Yes, and many others, application like autonomous driving, etc. And those applications should be connected through the network. In this case, it's through the internet network, something like that. Okay. So far, is there any questions?
No, sir, not yet.
Can I ask a question?
Oh, okay, please.
From your demo of SDF, is it? I see it's using Linux software.
Yes. Yes, correct.
What is the language that is used in the Linux? Is it Python or maybe other thing, other language?
For the programming.
Yes.
Not really specify into certain programming language. It's not mentioned, but it used GNU Radio Companion.
Oh,
yeah, something like that. I'm not sure what kind of a programming that they use, but it's kind of block programming. Yeah, you just attach block to another block. And also, if you are interested in more, this general block can be a program more advanced, something like that. But back to your question, what kind of programming language that use in radio or GNU Radio Companion is not mentioned clearly.
Oh, okay. Yes. Thank you.
Yeah.
Well, because I see at the output language in your demo, it's using Python.
Oh, really?
Yes. I see small writings that is mentioned using Python.
Oh, okay. Interesting. Thank you very much for your information. Actually, honestly, I'm not really familiar with the Python programming language that currently being used in many applications. That's a good programming, I believe, that maybe I'm the old people that use the old programming language. Actually, I'm familiar with the Java, C, or I forgot Java, C, and C++, and some. And for the Python, I'm not so familiar. So I just realized that that's kind of a Python programming, and that's good. And thank you very much for this information, RV.
Cool. Yes, thank you as well, sir.
Yes. Okay, any other question? No? If no, we continue, yeah? Okay. How many of you that ever hear about the Shannon theory? I just asking. Maybe please raise your hand to those who are familiar or even heard about the Shannon theory. Shannon. Nobody? Shannon. Have you ever heard?
Never heard of it, sir.
Never? Oh, okay. Okay, no problem. So nobody here, yeah? Nobody about the Shannon theory, Shannon, yeah. Before we going more about this, Shannon theory is invented by Shannon, yeah, of course. Actually, what is the we try to the formula that they have been he has been invented. Yeah, this is one, not E. Yeah. This is one. So Shannon tell us, yeah, or formulate this is the information capacity. Shannon quantify information. The point is Shannon can quantify information. What? Information can be quantified? Yes. Shannon said that information, the total information or capacity information is affected by SNR and bandwidth. SNR, if you remember that the SNR is related to the power of signal divided power of noise. So, how much information that can be received or can be transferred is really depend on the how much power of the signal information. It's proportional, yeah. When we use a high power, then we can send or receive many information. We can use a lower power, we can only send or receive small information. And also the information proportional to the bandwidth. When the bandwidth is larger, is large, and then we can put many information on them. And then if we have a smaller bandwidth or narrow bandwidth, and then we can only send a small informations. That's the Shannon formula. And to those who are interested in telecommunication engineering, I think you have to clearly understand about this formula, because the Shannon formula, Shannon limit, yeah, this is a grandfather of telecommunication, yeah. Kalau bahasa kekiniannya, mbahnya telekomunikasi. Yes. Because of Shannon, we can develop the current communication technology. Yeah, I mean, initiated by Shannon. Yeah. Using this formula, and this formula is still works until today. Until 5G or even 6G and beyond. Yes. Okay. Now talking about this formula, yeah, there are many comments from the from the expert. People say that the wireless industry has reached the theoretical limits of how fast network can go. Another, we are 90% on the way to the barrier known as Shannon limits. But another people also say there is no theoretical maximum to the amount of data that can be carried by a radio channel. Yes. So this kind of contradiction, some partly are correct, some partly are wrong, some partly are in generally correct, but in some part are wrong. Okay. In the third sentence, we are at the sentence limits. You follow this party, or you follow this party. The Sanon was wrong. There is no limits. And what would Sanon say? We don't know the Sanon capacity of most wireless channel. Oh, Sanon don't know. Wow. Okay. That's because, yeah, actually the Sanon is correct, but this theory should be adjusted into certain condition. If you take a look to the formula that the capacity, Sanon capacity, belong to bandwidth log by 2 SNR plus 1. And you remember that SNR is a comparison ratio between power signal and the power noise. From this point, actually the capacity is unlimited. As long as you have unlimited power, and as long as you can suppress the noise, that's the point. If you have a lot of power, you can send as many as possible the information, something like that. The only limitation is the device. Yes, device. Since the device, usually the current device compared to the past device or even device are different in terms of performance. Yeah, performance, complexity, reliability, and sensitivity. Usually, a good device, we can consider as a good sensitive device. When a device can sense a very small of power, that's good. Means that they no need to put an amplifier to detect a small noise, a small signal. And as the power of signal getting larger, and then we can easily detect the signal itself, something like that. Okay. Back to the wireless channel, yeah. Sanon capacity is really again depend on the time varying channel, yeah. There are additional factor in wireless communication to apply the Sanon limits. There is a time varying channel, means that the channel is fluctuated by times compared to the wire or guided channel. Guided channel will more stable. That's why wire connection is always better than wireless connection. You can prove using from the router access point, wireless router access point, compared to the local area network cable or LAN cable. Maybe you can experience with two computer, the both streaming with the same high definition quality from YouTube, for example. Once computer you attach to the or you connect it to the internet through LAN cable, and then once just connected through to the wireless router, and then you will see the experience, will see the quality of the video, and the wired connection is still better than the wireless connection. Yeah, in general condition. Yeah, in comparative or logical comparative. Yeah, something like that. Since the wireless channel experience time varying channel means that the signal propagate in the wireless channel are up and down and prone to be unstable, something like that. Because of interference, something like that. Okay, the number two, channel with interference or relay. Yeah, also the effect of interference and relay, the capacity become more challenging to be defined. Yeah, again, a cellular system that we use a reuse frequency to increase the capacity, something like that. So we have to define the Shannon capacity in certain condition. Ad hoc network and sensor network. Also, it is also a different things. Yeah, channel with the delay, energy, and money constraint. Yeah, you know that the channel, how to develop channel, how to build a channel is really considered about the delay, energy, and the investment cost. So, arrive at this point, Shannon theory provides design insight and system performance upper bounds. Means that we can apply the Shannon capacity formula to design as a reference design, design insight, to achieve a certain system performance at the top limit. Okay, we move forward talking about the current and next generation wireless network. Currently, we are enjoying high performance wireless network that we can call 4G LTE. I believe that your smartphone all are 5G capable. And maybe in 10 years ahead, we are experiencing 5G, 6G wireless, because 5G is currently deploying. And then in certain country, they are already deployed about millimeter massive MIMO system. And also satellite system, for example, Starlink, developed by Elon Musk. Bluetooth, Zigbee, WiGig, yes. And the emerging 5G technology, 7G Wi-Fi system, ad hoc and cognitive radio network, energy harvesting system, means that the system that not power only by the battery, but powered by harvesting system. The harvesting system, for example, by mechanical system. For example, the beta S equipped by the turbine fan. So the turbine fan can generate electricity power to power up the beta S, or chemical molecular communications. This emerging technology is much room for innovation. Yes. Also, we are talking about the spectral reuse. This is kind of technique to improve the capacity. You can see here, this is the 2G cellular system works. So the area is split by cell. You can see here the hexagonal is cell, which the beta S is the center point here, broadcast serving the certain area with a certain frequency planning. Different color mean that the different spectrum frequency. This kind of frequency reuse, you can see here, blue color, there is a repetition, blue color in certain distance. This kind of application of frequency reuse means that we use a frequency, same frequency in different locations. And why the use of frequency should be a gap here, a gap should be a certain distance because to avoid interference. If the maybe the blue one here and blue one here, it's possible to experience interference that will deteriorate the performance of wireless system. That's the concept of cellular. And the cellular or other commercial technology, wireless commercial technology, they use license band. Means that this band, this spectrum frequency is not free, not gratisan. Yeah, it should be pay. Who is pay? Who pays for this license is operator, telecommunication operator. To who? To the government. Yeah. So the operator pays the license spectrum to the government. And also the government provide the unlicensed band. The unlicensed bands, for example, if you experience with the Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi works in 2.0 gigahertz. This unlicensed bands. That's why many people use this. Many technology use this, and many people deploy Wi-Fi because no regulation on this spectrum. It is permissible to everyone to set up Wi-Fi everywhere, anywhere, yeah, without void of regulation. But it is not permitted everyone to develop telecommunication system in 90 megahertz spectrum because this is license band. For example, in FM radio, yeah, FM radio also license band from 88 to the 108. This is license band, means that we can broadcast information, any information through this spectrum, bandwidth spectrum without license. So it is a void allow, yeah, individual to broadcast radio or broadcast information because it has been regulated. And you can see here, because this is unlicensed bands, many technology use it, and this spectrum become crowded. So because of this, usually we are experience bad connection in the public service, in the public facility, Wi-Fi public facility, because there are many Wi-Fi and then gets interference each other. And this mechanism, this interference can downgrade performance of connection. Okay, this kind of a cellular system, and this is the like a 4G LTE cellular. Usually the spec of the 5G is much higher data rates than 3G, and then greater spectral efficiency, flexible use up to 100 megahertz spectrum, low packet frequency latency below 5 milliseconds, and reduced cost per bit, not clear to customer. This is it's mean that for investment perspective, or yeah, to those operator, they want to invest the 4G, something like that. And also the important thing is all IP networks. And this is a 5G upgrade from 4G. You can see here the 5G usually support 3 points. First is extreme mobile broadband, means that you will be experience mobile broadband service when you are maybe in a car or in the train. You can still streaming with high definition quality with 5G. And then to support massive machine communication, this is particularly for IoT device connections, and also critical machine communications. This is particularly for autonomous driving. The autonomous driving is should be low latency requirements. You can imagine that, for example, in the driving mode, self-driving mode, and you want to avoid collision, and the collision is happen in less than or in very short time, and this should be avoided. You can consider if this communication is with high latency, maybe it's potential to be accidents. So to avoid this, we should provide a low latency communication to provide the accidents. Future cellular phone, everything wireless in one device. And you can see here, you are experience laptop or PC level performance. Yeah, you experience with camera pro performance, or like Samsung device or iPhone device currently support for pro cellular or cinematic recording, which is you can focus in a different object in single times. Also, you are experience with your communication for gaming, for video recording, yeah, like a cinematic, yeah, for video streaming, or even for wearable devices to monitor your heartbeat, you monitor your oxygen level, and so on and so on. Sorry. And the future cellular phone also capable to deliver many gig of data. And impact of this, of course, they will burden for the backbone, because the backbone should bring many or terabit gigs of data, yeah, terabit data. So the backbone should be high performance, can deliver high amount of data. Okay. Also, Wi-Fi, you can see that Wi-Fi become everywhere. Wi-Fi network become everywhere. Yeah, as I mentioned at the beginning of this course. Yeah, to perform streaming video, gigabit data rates to gaming and transferring many data, multivariate of data, many types of data. Yeah. And this is the evolution of wireless LAN technology. And the point is that the point of coexistence means that your wireless LAN technology should be able to perform connection, the old one, the middle age, and even for the current technology, current generations. And you can see here from the beginning, with the standard of 802.11b and evolution, yeah, with the A and B and A G and A C and A X, X mean and undefined. X is still not be defined. Yes. Also, this is more important. Maybe you are experienced with why does Wi-Fi performance suck? Yeah, because there is no regulation, many interferers over there. Yes, that's why the performance of Wi-Fi is not good, particularly in the public facility, in public infrastructure, in the stations, train station, something like that. And so that's why it is important to Wi-Fi that for having a self-organizing network, self-organizing network to avoid interference, to improve the capacity so they can optimize the network, something like that. Also, when we are talking about the wireless communication, also we are talking about the satellite system. There are many types of satellite. There is a geo, MEO, LEO. Yeah, geo means that the distance from the Earth is around 39,000 kilometers. MEO is around 9,000 kilometers. And for the LEO is 2,000 kilometers, something like that. And this communication, the satellite communication, is not only for communication or commercial purpose, but also for military purpose. Bluetooth also, usually is intended to short-range communications, works in 2.5 gigahertz band. The data rate is up to 3 megabit per second. Widely supported by telecommunication, PC, and consumer electronic company. And ZigBee also, it's if you are to those who playing Arduino, yeah, ZigBee very familiar, yeah, for communication module. Spectrum regulation, we are to anticipate spectrum scarcity. Yeah, so the spectrum should be regulated. The spectral allocation in Indonesia controlled by Kementerian Kominfo. Kominfo auction spectral blocks for set application, particularly for telecommunication operator. Moreover, for the worldwide level, the spectrum also been regulated by the regulation body that we can say ITU, International Telecommunication Union. This is the regulation body in telecommunication field in the world level. And also standard. Standard, it is important. Standard to make sure that other device can be interoperability, can work together. Standard also important to guarantee the performance, quality of service. Okay. Finally, we arrive at the summary of our lecture. Main point, the wireless vision encompasses many exciting applications that might be never before. Yeah, never think before. Yeah, been thinking before. Yeah, technical challenge transcend all system design layers. 5G network must support higher performance for some user, extreme energy efficiency, and or low latency for other. Cloud-based software to dynamically control and optimize wireless network needed. Yeah, software-defined wireless network. Innovation or innovative wireless design needed for 5G cellular or Wi-Fi, millimeter wave system, MIMO system, and IoT connectivity. Standards and spectral allocation heavily impact the evolution of wireless technology. And yes, actually there are a backup slide to those who are interested in more in this topic. For example, rethinking cellular, you can read this rest of this slide. And to those who are interested in maybe wants to discuss more, you can read this, and who are not understand yet, you can ask me next week. Okay, there are still around 10 slides that you can study more about this topic, and you can ask me if you don't understand, and then we discuss next week. Okay. Until this point, until this summary, is there any questions?
Sir, I have a question.
Yes, please.
Just now when you were talking about the Shannon limit, the capacity is related also to the bandwidth, and you said that there can be no